this Ghanaian family that took me like their daughter.
Okay.
So I stayed until I left that house. I think I stayed in that house for 2 years.
Okay.
Until I left that apartment, I never did. And I want to even eat that food they call food for the girls.
Okay, welcome to my channel once again. Welcome. Today, I don't know how to call it, whether a conversation or an interview, because I have a Nigerian here, a Nigerian lady that I'm very sure some of you have seen her face before. And if you don't know her too, this is going to be the first time that you are going to do what? See her and also know her. She has a channel, she is also a content creator, so I would love if you can go, you know, down the description. I have her link, her YouTube link or her channel link there. Please go there and do what? Subscribe to her channel first of all and do what? Get to know what she posts or uploads on her channel so that you can follow her and help her to also grow. And she's actually living in Ghana, so she's going to show you Ghana a lot. What I want to know is your name first.
Okay.
So yes, your name.
Kina Bife. Yes.
Does it have a meaning? Like the meaning, the Bife or the
Bife
Kina?
Is victory.
Victory.
Yes.
Ah, okay. And the Kina is like your surname.
Yes.
Ah, okay. But my question is, this interview that we are doing, we are in Ghana.
Yeah.
And she is a Nigerian.
Mm-hmm.
Why are you in Ghana? Like, what? Okay, you let me ask, why are you in Ghana? Why Ghana?
Actually, I came here for my studies.
You came here for your studies?
Yes, years back.
I came here for my studies years back.
2014, there about 2013, 2014.
Okay,
so yeah,
that's like a very long time.
Yeah.
So, like, when did you complete?
I went back to Nigeria 2018. Yes, and then I went back to Nigeria 2019.
So meaning, you stayed for like a year.
Oh yes.
Okay.
Stayed for a year, and then I went back. Yeah.
Then I think 4 years in Ghana. So, when did you decide to come back?
It's not like I decided to come back. I actually came back for something different.
Something different?
Yes, not to come and stay. Not to come and reside.
Okay.
Yes, but on coming back, I'm like, let me venture into my business here. I felt Ghana had a prospect.
Okay.
That I was looking for, so I decided to venture into my business and my food business.
Okay, so what do you do? What actually do you do?
Nigerian,
you said your business. So
yes,
what do you do?
I'm a cook, so
okay.
I do Nigerian food here in Accra.
Okay.
So for events,
okay,
for your food in liters, I don't do plates. I don't do. I want to eat this afternoon. I want lunch, so I want 1 plate of food. No. I do food for liters.
She wants contracts based on contracts.
Yes.
Contracts.
So Nigerian soups,
okay,
Nigerian stews, Nigerian sauces, jollof rice. Let's start Ghana, Nigeria.
But you, I'm coming. Do you know something?
Let's start.
You've been in Ghana for all these years.
Yeah.
So my question is, haven't you learned how to cook any Ghanaian food?
Oh, I know how to cook some Ghanaian dishes.
Because you were saying Nigerian dishes, Nigerian.
Oh yes.
That.
Why I said so is because that's my specialty.
Okay.
Yes, that's where I specialize.
Okay.
But if you want Ghanaian food,
yeah,
I have a Ghanaian that I work with.
Okay.
Yes, I have a Ghanaian that I work with. And then when Ghanaian orders come in, I don't joke with my customers, so I cannot come and gamble with their stomach and say I want to use their stomach to learn how to prepare meals.
Okay, I understand.
Yes, until I get very conversant with
the Ghanaian dishes.
Preparing the Ghanaian dishes, then I'll be bold enough to say I'll cook the Ghanaian dishes for my customers. But I prepare them at home for myself, yes.
All right. I think that's a good business, because when you're in Ghana, definitely you are a foreigner. when you come, you need to find yourself something doing.
Yeah, it's but very... I have Ghanaians that patronize me.
Yeah.
Nigerian dishes, and they really love it.
Yeah, I think I've gone to some few Nigerian places that they sell Nigerian food, and I see Ghanaians there. They mm-hmm. buy Nigerian food. So
it's very delicious.
Yeah,
they enjoy it.
You know, the thing is, all of us. Well, let's not go into that like that topic now. So let me go back again. What course actually did you come to learn in Ghana, and what school?
I did journalism and mass communication.
Journalism and mass communication.
Yes.
At what school?
Sikkim Manipal University, currently Academic City College.
Where is it located?
It was located at SECO.
SECO, okay.
Yes, but now...
Like, okay, they were at SECO.
Yes.
Okay. And my question is, since you came to Ghana, what have you seen that you've lived almost all your life in Nigeria?
Yes.
And is Ghana the first ever country that you traveled to, apart from Nigeria?
So. Yes. Ghana,
okay.
Was. Yes.
So, what did you see? What differences did you see traveling to Ghana the first day that you came?
First off,
the first day that you stepped your foot here.
I thought there would be a lot of difference.
Okay.
You know, with the buildings, the
okay.
environment and everything,
okay.
but not much of a difference. So when I came in, it was as if I was in Nigeria, but maybe in another state.
A mini Nigeria.
First off, then a lot of other changes, a lot of other differences too.
Okay.
We have the electricity, we have the peace,
okay.
we have the people, we have the culture, we have the food. Some of those things were a bit, you know, different for me.
Okay.
Yeah, but as time went on, I started integrating myself into the culture very well.
And you know, say for the whole school that you went, like the school, for the whole duration. How was it, let's say you being a foreigner, or you had a lot of foreigners in that school?
Oh yes.
A lot of foreigners in that
yes.
school. So like you
school
were in,
was dominated by Nigerians.
By Nigerians,
yes.
Okay.
Because
so it wasn't like there were a lot of Ghanaians there.
My class, I can't remember up to 5 Ghanaians.
Okay.
Yes, my school was dominated by Nigerians and Francophones. Nigerians,
I think one thing is most Ghanaians prefer going to KNSC and Legon, UCC, UEW, you know, the government schools, because
yeah.
mostly the fees there is not that much compared
yes.
to the private schools.
Yeah.
Because the private schools, to be
they're
honest,
very expensive.
Charlie,
I know, right.
They
and
charge
the
lot.
The sad part is that we foreigners pay
more.
Yes.
But this thing, you know, I think I was talking with somebody and the person was like, even abroad, it's the same.
Yes, foreigners pay more.
Foreigners pay
yes,
more. That's what they say. Foreigners pay more. So it's something that actually cuts across. It's
yes,
more,
it's not just in Ghana.
Like just in Ghana.
That's true.
That meaning, you guys, because I think I remember some time ago, I heard someone's fees, and I was like, really? In dollars?
Oh, yes, they pay in dollars.
Why are we in Ghana and people are paying dollars? Like,
I think we are not ready to venture into that discussion because
no, it doesn't make sense.
One,
me,
it's a long
yeah,
one.
Yeah. Like for me, it doesn't make sense.
It's,
we are in Ghana.
We are
why
black,
should
we are West Africans?
So why
let
should
let me not even go to East Africa? We are West Africans, and then we have to pay in dollars to school.
It doesn't make sense. It doesn't make sense. Honestly,
well, thank God so far.
And the same people will be telling us to. Like to not sell or do anything, transact business in dollars, especially like we that we are in the real estate business.
Oh, they don't want people to pay in dollars.
Like sell in
to
dollars.
Sell in dollars.
We are not serious. This country and
it's really sad.
Africa in general. Sometimes, but you schooling here throughout. What were some of the good moments that you can share with us, and what were some of the bad moments? Because you know, sometimes did you stay in a hostel or you rented an apartment?
I never stayed in a hostel.
You rented an apartment?
Yes.
Okay, so the apartment that you rented, you know, we have this perception around that a lot of Nigerians, when they go to rent a place in Ghana especially, they don't usually get it. You know, the landlords will say no to them, like to Nigerians mostly, because of certain stuff that some Nigerians, some few Nigerians, let me put it that way, have created in the country. So I'm just asking if you faced that challenge ever.
I faced one with my landlord.
Okay.
The ever first place I rented.
Okay.
I don't think it's because I'm a Nigerian. I just feel it's him, right?
Okay.
He was supposed to do something, a porch for me.
All right.
When I was paying the rent, he said he was going to do this particular porch for me. I need to do it in 2 months' time. So I stayed until I left that house. I think I stayed in that house for 2 years.
Okay.
Until I left that apartment, he never did. So I don't think it's because I'm a Nigerian. I just feel it's him. I don't think he wants to do that to me because I'm a Nigerian.
You know, that's why sometimes I feel like the rent control in Ghana, I think the government should try and make it an authority. You know, when it just, I think they are rent control agency or something. I've forgotten
what it is. Yes, in fact,
they're just like agency.
At the time, they told me to go through that route, and I'm like, see, I'm
it's
here
very
to
long.
School.
Yeah,
I'm here to school. True. I'm not here to fight with anyone or have issues with anyone. As long as no one is coming into my space or threatening me, it's fine. If this is what he feels is okay for him, that's good. I'm fine. I don't have anyone here, so I can just say I want to start dragging in Ghanaian. Like, no, I wasn't in for that. I just lived, and then when it was time for me to leave, I left.
That's why it's good when you rent a place. I'm sure abroad, if you went into any agreement like what you were saying with the landlord, it has to be stated.
Oh, it was.
Like in a written form, so that.
It was.
So that could have been an evidence to just like take him on, but you chose the peaceful way. But
yes.
You chose the peaceful way.
I know some of my classmates
they are very stubborn. Yes. Landlords, they are very, very
stubborn.
They had
issues with their landlords and they were dragging rent control police. I wasn't sure I wanted to go through that route. So I just left it.
You guys should change it. No, they should change. Because these things, it doesn't look nice. Why would someone come and rent your place? The person is like giving you money.
Mm-hmm.
And instead of you to treat the person the right way, just... So, apart from that experience, what other bad experience did you ever had? Maybe just give us some two like bad experiences when you were
bad
in school
experience.
at that time, yeah.
Bad experiences. My stay in Ghana was peaceful. If I would say bad experiences, I don't think all of my stay in Ghana then, I met any Ghanaian that treated me bad.
Bad, okay.
I don't think so. Let's ignore maybe going to the shop to buy something and people just give attitude. I mean, personally treating me bad. I can't think of any. I can't recall any.
No, like this thing that you said right now, for that one, I think it's a Ghanaian. I think it's a Ghanaian attitude. It's when it comes to Ghanaians that sell, when it comes to customer service, I'll give my people 30%.
You know, I talked about this on my channel and I was dragged.
Forget, it is true.
I was dragged, but I just feel if you could do better.
No, you know, they are in their comfort zone. They are in their comfort zone, so that's how they are going to behave. So allow them. Allow them.
So I don't think I had any bad
bad experience. Experience.
The Ghanaians I met, I didn't mingle a lot when I was in school there. So maybe that's why maybe I don't have a lot of experience. I didn't mingle a lot. But the few Ghanaians I mingled with, even the Nigerians, I didn't mingle with them a lot.
Okay.
So my routine was just school, house, church, my friend's house, just like that. So my experiences were awesome. Yeah.
Alright, so I've spoken about the bad experience. What about the good experiences too?
Oh, first of all, I'm grateful to Ghana for the opportunity to come here and learn.
Okay.
Yes, so that's a very good experience for me.
Okay.
The learning experience. Right. Even if my school was not a government school, so the foreign school, but the fact that I schooled in Ghana was an awesome experience.
Okay.
And my experiences were good. Which one will I even pinpoint? I don't even know the particular one.
Just give us like two.
Okay, the fact that I met this Ghanaian family that took me like their daughter.
Okay.
Yes, a couple with their children, and I could go there in the morning. Then they ensure, like they take me like their daughter. They ensure that I eat, they ensure that I'm fine, I'm well, I'm not sick. Even when, there was a time I had some issues, and they pursued that issue like their own, took it up upon themselves. So that was a beautiful experience for me, having that family to integrate with, knowing that I left home. So having a family that I could call family in Ghana, it was something special to me. So yes, it was a beautiful experience for me, having that family.
Okay. So you've had your good experiences and all that. When it comes to Ghana itself, in general, not your personal experience, how do you see the country? How do you see Ghana in general?
I wouldn't want to go into politics because I'm not a politician.
Oh, feel free. Listen, on my channel. Because we're a foreigner, you might...
No, even if it's my country, I wouldn't want to go into politics.
Okay.
Hands are not there.
Okay. All right. So
yes, but generally,
Ghana
is a peaceful country.
Okay.
Ghana is a country where you get to see a lot of foreigners.
Yeah.
I've not been to other countries.
Yeah.
Just like you said earlier, Ghana was my first country that I visited aside my
own country.
So you get to see a lot of foreigners.
Yeah.
And then they are working freely.
Yeah.
You know. They are working peacefully.
Yeah.
So it's something that is interesting to know. And then for me, I would say the banter between Nigeria and Ghana. I'm really getting more interested
in that
because I want to really know what happened. I know there was this Ghana Moscow, and then they said first Ghana was, Ghana chased Nigeria.
The little that I have learnt is that I think it all started when Ghana got its independence. I think that's what I have learned, though. That's when it started. That's when a lot of Nigerians came to Ghana, and because the country has gotten independent and they are doing everything by themselves and all that, so it attracted a lot of I think not even only like Nigerians, right? You know, one thing is between these two countries, I think this thing, let me say it, no matter what happens, if there is a war in Ghana, most Ghanaians will feel so comfortable. Voltairians that I would say their language and their culture is almost like the people in Togo. Apart from these people, the Akans and all the other tribes that you see, most of them will feel comfortable in Nigeria than any other country. So automatically, a lot of Ghanaians would definitely go to Nigeria.
And vice versa.
Vice versa, exactly. Same thing, because we have a lot of things in common. And we have a history to that. Like what I spoke about, when Ghana got its own independence, Nigerians came. That's what I learned. They came, they were in the country, and I think what actually happened was when this our first president, like the coups happened. I think the next president also, or the next prime minister also, was the one who commanded. I think the Ghanaian the foreigners to do what, to leave, something like that. And I think the Nigerian one to something similar happened, because I've listened to a certain audio when the Nigerian president was also asking foreigners to do what, to leave. But you know, it has become Ghana and Nigeria because the foreigners that were in Ghana then, most of them were Nigerians, and vice versa, the same thing happened in
Nigeria.
They said over 2 million foreigners, and 1 million or over 1 million of them were Ghanaians. So that's like the story. But it seems like the one that Ghana did not really gain that much, I don't know what
sure?
I should call, media attention or something. Or maybe, okay, maybe, like, let me put it that way, like this way. We never tagged it.
Okay, but we tagged that on Ghana Mosque.
Exactly. So, you know, anything that you give it a slogan, it just... So perhaps that's the difference, but
I'm going to interview someone on that.
Okay, like someone who was there at that time.
Especially when it happened in the both countries.
Okay. Then I think that would be
a
very interesting.
I really want to hear the real background story.
Okay.
Because I don't see Ghanaians fight other countries like the way they come for Nigeria. And I don't see Nigerians go for other countries like the way they fight Ghana.
Yeah.
And these same countries love themselves so much.
No, we have a lot.
So,
we do a lot of things together.
Common,
a lot,
and we have
a lot
in common.
A lot.
But it's all love.
Yeah.
It's all love.
These things forget.
Like,
oh, they are just listen. These things they are
love.
Just on social media.
Yes, in reality.
In reality, nothing.
It's
doesn't
all
happen.
Love. Trust me.
In reality, it doesn't happen. Forget.
It's all
nobody.
Love.
No Nigerian will see a Ghanaian and be like, forget nothing.
It's all love in
nothing.
Reality.
So I think for Ghana and Nigeria, they just put their stuff out there like somewhere. It's just on social media.
Yeah, I know.
It's just on social media. So you being in Ghana, you experiencing, like you having your bad experience and your good experiences. What has been some of the, should I say, fun things that you've done in Ghana? Saying you traveling to places, going here, coming here, or like you would say you stayed in, like in Accra the whole 4 years, and you never traveled to any place.
I think I only traveled, most of the Swedru. I went to Swedru. That then I was working.
I was working in Swedru. Yeah, I was working in Swedru.
Then I was working, so we traveled for a job.
Okay.
Then I think we spent a day. We slept there. It was like overnight.
Okay.
And then we traveled to Kumasi. Also for
another one.
So I think those are the places I've gone to.
Really? So you've
not traveled? Yes, I've not traveled. That's why I have come back.
And then
I have returned.
Then you have a lot of work to do.
Don't worry. Come on my channel, you will see.
Because
I will
in Ghana...
I'm going to explore Ghana.
Mm-hmm.
I'm going to explore their dishes. Because, you know, my perception is that I feel, Ghanaians don't have a lot of food.
Hey, food.
That's why I said my perception. But in the comment section, like when I say that in the comment section, people say, oh, you've not gone to so place. You've not gone to so place. And yes, I'm just in Accra. So I can't use Accra to judge
the whole of Ghana.
So I want to really travel to explore Ghana, to know their dishes, to try their dishes. And I want to even eat that food they call food for the girls.
Eto.
Eto.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. I want to try all of those things. Yeah. I want to really see Ghana.
Ghana, okay. In different states and nature.
You know, they're like, Kumasi is different from Accra.
Yeah. Kumasi is different.
Yes. Kumasi is different. Just 24 hours I spent in Kumasi, I felt Kumasi is way different from
and
Accra.
And the culture thing there is more like you feel it or you see it more than Accra.
Yes.
Yeah, because Accra those people
just
are like traditional
commercial state where
exactly,
people
yeah.
from east, west, north and
everybody
south come to come and make money.
Exactly.
So
thing.
I want to really travel out to explore the whole Ghanaian culture.
Okay, so you've not traveled much.
No, I haven't. But I will.
Okay. You have to, because Ghana, I am even trying to travel to almost every popular, and I've traveled to a lot of places though, but creating content, I want to travel to some of the most popular towns and villages and cities that we have in Ghana.
Local
places too is very interesting, like the villages here.
That's
very interesting.
The
real content here. That's also good, like going to be a very good like experience. Okay, so when it comes to food, what and what have you tried? You said you are into food, so when it comes to the Ghanaian
food,
what
Bangu
and what have you tried? Bangu and tilapia and fufu.
No, Bangu and tilapia.
Okay.
And then fufu. When I mean Bangu and tilapia, I mean grilled
grilled,
and
Bangu
and pepper.
Okay.
And then fufu.
Okay.
Of course, why would I eat? Fufu and
light soup, okay.
I've tried some light soup, I've even tried, I don't know the name.
We have light soup, we have groundnut soup, that's the peanut. Butter
so
soup.
I've not tried to brown
that
soup.
One.
Not because I don't like it. Maybe I've not had the opportunity. But I love the palm nut soup.
Palm nut, okay.
Because I can relate.
And the bunabuno.
The green one.
The green one.
I've not tried it.
You've not tried that one too.
I've tried the kontomire.
Okay.
And egg sauce.
Kontomire. We call it palava sauce.
With
abushi there, like the one that you guys use for your
it's really nice though. See,
like the one that you guys use for your like what's the name of the soup?
Egusi soup.
When
I was in Ghana, when I was a student then,
yeah,
my go-to food for those days where money is not there, is either palava sauce and
eba.
No, not about.
Oh, that one too, like,
I'm not eating it before.
Try it.
Hey.
I'm telling you, try it.
Okay, I do go for palava sauce and yam, or egg sauce and yam. So, it became like one of my staple.
Okay.
So,
I think
palava sauce, yeah.
No, palava sauce, I like it mostly, I eat it with rice and plantain or yam.
I don't like it with rice. Yam gives a different kind of flavor and taste.
So apart from these foods, you've not tried any other food again? I know that you recently went to town and did a
those are street food.
Street food videos. And I just want to ask this, amongst all the foods that you tried, or the street ones that you tried, which one or which ones were your favorites?
I would like all its food. Well, I actually captured it, so I'll call it a street food. Coconut kube,
okay.
I love it. I love asana.
Asana, yeah. Asana, mostly we like when you add milk to it, it's like you are drinking malt.
Exactly.
Yeah, it's like you are drinking malt.
Exactly. So yeah, kube, asana. I think those are my best. Yeah, when it comes to street, because I'm not really a street.
You've not tried Nkati cake.
What is Nkati cake?
Nkati cake is it's peanuts, but they grind it a bit. It doesn't.
It's not well crushed.
Well crushed, like a flour or something, a bit rough, and they just should I say fry
with sugar.
It with sugar? Yeah.
I've not tasted that thing. I know what I'm talking about. Then they will mold it and then cut it.
Exactly.
I've not tasted into
blocks.
Yes.
Like that.
Yes. That will be sugary.
Very.
Running away from sugar.
Very, very
say
sugary.
No to sugar. Say no
very,
to
very,
sugar.
Very, very, very sugary. Okay, so, okay. So, you've not traveled to many places in Ghana.
No,
you've
no.
not tried like
no,
most
tried
of our foods,
most of
foods and all that. Okay, I think there is one question that I want to ask.
Okay.
This thing is a very common or normal thing for life for ladies. Since the time that you came to Ghana to date, what has been the experience when it comes to Ghanaian men or guys approaching you? What has been the experience?
I wouldn't say a lot of experience.
Experience.
Well, a lot of experience. I wouldn't say that. But I think it's still the same thing with Nigerians.
Like they approach you. I'm trying to know how they approach you. How do they approach you? And is it a proper way?
Well, you can't approach me in an improper way. Personally. Oh, personally, you won't approach me in an improper way.
Because when the person does,
yeah,
like you
no,
don't mind the person.
No, like. The way I present myself to you,
okay,
you have
yeah,
you the
know,
guts
okay,
to do
okay,
that.
Okay, I get it.
You won't disrespect me because I won't disrespect you, so I wouldn't expect disrespect
from you.
Yes.
Okay.
So I don't think I have issues with that. I don't think I have issues with that.
But they've been coming.
Oh, people
all the
will
time.
Come.
All the
people
time.
Will come.
And
you are a lady, so people will definitely
come.
It's how you handle
them
that matters.
Yeah.
People will actually come.
Because I think it's something that some ladies have a problem with.
Okay.
I don't know. And I say, you are in your prime. It's a normal
okay,
thing.
Like people coming to you.
It's
well,
a,
it's, I feel
you are
it's,
in your prime. It's a normal thing.
I feel it's normal.
Yeah. The because when they are not even coming, then meaning, Charlie,
it's a problem.
Why? Are you a ghost or something?
Then it's
that's
a problem.
It. Yeah. So
people will come.
Exactly.
First is how you carry yourself. That's much how they will present themselves
Sounds
to you.
You. Yeah.
And also, even when they present themselves to you, it's also how you respond to them.
Okay. Yeah.
That
yeah,
also
true,
matters.
True, true, true.
So as for coming, they will come. It's
okay.
Normal.
And has there been any bad experience with that, or some experience that you said, oh no, this one, this guy was kind of like the way he approached me. If I was supposed to even give in or give him a try, I would have. Or someone said, oh no, this guy, why did he approach me this way?
Oh no. I don't think I've experienced something like
You've
that.
You've not had any experience like that?
Nah, I haven't.
Okay.
I haven't.
So everybody approaches you nicely. Or you feel the way you, like you, like, as you said, you presented yourself or you've presented yourself.
I've not had, first off, just like I said earlier,
yeah.
The way you carry yourself
is
the way people also carry you.
That's true. That's
Do you
true.
Understand?
Yeah.
I'm not saying people that they've disrespected, it means that they didn't carry themselves
well. Yeah.
Okay, but I'm just saying, for me,
yeah.
I don't think I will allow anybody to disrespect me.
Yeah.
So, for once, I've not experienced that.
Okay.
Not in Ghana.
Okay.
I haven't experienced that with the Ghanaian men. Mm-hmm. So, I wouldn't say Ghanaian men are bad or they are good.
Okay.
You get. I cannot judge.
No, I understand.
I cannot judge.
Yeah, I understand.
Okay. But it's been awesome experience.
Okay.
Like I've not had any issue with any Ghanaian.
Okay. I think that's it seems like for you, as you said, the way you carry yourself is
Maybe let me say this. Maybe I told you that when I was here, my routine was just house,
school,
church, my friends' place, all my friends' places. And, you know, I was in Ghana for that long, and I went to the vitrine twice. Yes, I went to the beach. So, and it was work that took me to the beach. Went to shoot a video at the beach. It was that bad. So maybe I did not really mingle
a lot with people.
So I didn't experience a lot of things.
Yeah, I guess.
Do you get? Maybe if I had mingled with people a lot, I would have had more experiences. I just feel my coming to Ghana is like a second chance for me to experience
and explore
Ghana
and explore more
things. Yeah.
I think that's also good. For me, so meaning you are an indoor person, kind of.
Yes, I was. Now I'm trying to. because I come out of your show. Yes.
And because of YouTube.
I have to step out.
Yeah, you have to.
And you have to look for opportunities.
Yeah, definitely.
You can't
definitely.
Be indoors and opportunities will meet you there. So you have to step out and look for opportunities.
That's my motivation. And you stepping out is like your YouTube. And
yes.
I will thank you so much for giving me this opportunity to do a video. And letting my people know the experiences that you've had, and you know these things, it also helps foreigners to, like anyone who wants to visit Ghana, to also know how the country is and all that. Because I know that a lot of people make a lot of research when they want to travel to a place. So this video might be a guide for someone who wants to travel to Ghana. So. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much.
And please don't forget to subscribe to her channel. Help her to grow and watch her videos. Like the video. You don't lose anything by liking videos. So just like it. Thank you for watching.
Thank you.